Welcome back, everyone. Time for Monday's meal. One of our favorite restaurants here in town, Benji's. We've got Chef Blake Keeley joining us this morning.
Well, great to have you here. Thanks for having us out again today. Mm-hmm. I appreciate it. Yeah.
And making an awesome dish I'm really excited about.
Yeah, I'm doing our coconut lime tuna ceviche. It's one of our ceviches of the day that we've been doing recently. We're kind of changing it out, keeping things fresh. But I'm going to start off always with a nice fresh piece of fish, tuna.
Look at that cut of tuna right there.
Bringing this fish in from Louisiana Seafood, one of the more respected seafood companies in town, always keeping up on the quality.
Yeah, that looks really nice.
We're going to first start off here doing a marinade in the blender here, the coconut lime. We're going to start off with a little coconut milk.
Oh, okay. I like the sound of this because, of course, you know, ceviche uses a lot of citrus, and this is kind of adding in a whole different flavor.
Yeah, we definitely have a touch of the citrus in to actually cook the meat a little bit with the citrus, but backing it up with a little nice creamy coconut milk.
Yeah. Does the we know the citrus kind of will cook the tuna a little bit if you leave it for too long. What about the coconut milk? Does that have any?
It does not have a cooking effect. It's just looking for that nice sweet creaminess effect to it, and the acid from the lime will do all the cooking.
And that actually coconut lime combination.
I know.
Sounds great.
Yeah, and we have a touch of a little ginger and serrano chili in there to give it a little heat.
Ooh,
we'll
yes.
puree that nice and smooth for the marinade. Come out, put on the tuna. I'm just going to marinate for about 20 minutes since we're using a nice fresh tuna. We don't want it to cook all the way through, just get the start of the cooking on there. Next, I'm going to go through with some nice garnish. Start with a little shallot, Fresno chili, it's kind of the red jalapeno, light heat, little color. You got a green onion or scallion, fresh cilantro.
Can't have Mexican without cilantro. Mm-mm.
A cucumber?
A little cucumber.
Oh, okay.
And fresh mint.
Ooh.
All right.
And then we always need a touch of salt to bring out the natural flavor. And I'm going to use a smoked chili lime sea salt here.
Oh, that sounds delicious. These are all great flavors you're blending
together
here. It
looks so healthy, too. And I mean, even if you've got that coconut milk, it looks
definitely,
good.
Yeah, definitely screams freshness.
Yes.
And we're just going to toss all those nice flavors together.
So you were saying you have a ceviche of the day there at Benji's.
That's correct. And this is just one of the many that we've been doing, anywhere from the far classic average ones to a little more new contemporary like this one.
Great.
And I'm already ready to plate up here. And we want to start with a base with an avocado, a little nice presentation there, and a ring mold to go into.
I love having the ceviche with the avocado.
And we'll scoop it right
into
the ring mold.
And if you're at home, you can add a little. I always like a little extra avocado, so you can.
Absolutely. You could dice it up, throw it in the mix as well. If you don't have a ring mold around, you can definitely just use a bowl, mix the avocado into it, diced up, and throw it across a plate with a little more of a rustic presentation.
That mold gives the nice presentation.
Yeah,
I know.
Definitely.
It
gives
it
a little more of the restaurant feel here, I guess. And we just want to give it a little press, let some of that juice from the ceviche come out.
Nice.
And oh, that's beautiful.
We're going to garnish with a little micro cilantro. The micro cilantro is just the sprouts of the cilantro giving a nice, delicate flavor.
I've never heard of that before.
I don't know if I've seen that. I mean, I probably have, but
you get all the nice flavor from the cilantro, but a lot more mild.
Yeah. Is this something you have on the menu for lunch and dinner?
It is, and we also are doing it as a brunch item out of the kitchen, that's another. We're starting our brunch buffet this week, is new to us at Benji's. We're really excited about, and this is an item that can come out of the kitchen nice and fresh as well.
Let me ask you real quick, what else do you have? Like, do you have the traditional migas and
traditional migas will definitely be one of them. King Ranch casserole, some of the more Americans like a jalapeno cheddar and waffles and fried chicken.
And the buffet, so you can get a little bit of everything.
That's right.
That sounds great. Got out brunch in Austin.
Biscuits and chorizo gravy as well. Wonderful experience. But to go along with this, you definitely want some tostadas, a little more of a heavy chip to hold up to that nice nice liquid.
Looks delicious, Chef. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
From Benji's, go out.
Having me out again.
And that brunch sounds amazing. Got to get out there soon.
Come on by.
Saturdays and Sundays or just Sundays?
Just Sundays.
Great. Check
Come
it out.
Come on by and see us. Thank you.